4th of July is right around the corner. It's this coming Wednesday. And when you think of getting party planning tips, who is probably one of the top people that you might want to get those party planning tips from in terms of cooking that food? Would it happen to be legendary chef from Iron Chef on the Food Network, the star of daytime talk show The Chew, and author of 9 cookbooks and the owner of 20 restaurants, Mario Batali? Well, you're just in luck because he is joining me right now to give some entertaining and party planning tips to help maybe those 4th of July parties or some other parties you plan on having this summer. Hi, Mario. How are you today?
Good, Brynn. Nice to hear. I mean, nice to talk to you. How's it going?
I'm great, and thank you for coming on the program. So when it comes to summer entertaining, what would you say are some of your favorite party tips?
Well, the biggest tip of all is to buy locally and shop regionally and seasonally so that you know what you're doing. Don't try to do winter stuff in the summer. Don't try to do things that aren't from where you are. And most importantly, decide how much effort it is that you want to put into the actual production of the meal when your guests are there. If you can do stuff in advance, then you're going to save yourself some time. You're going to be able to relax. And one of the big things about Italians, for example, if you go and you have a little coffee with an Italian and then everybody does the double cheek kiss and puts their jacket over their shoulders and saunters off into the sunset, everyone practiced all of that. So looking relaxed and being casual around whatever you do at your garden or in your barbecue or in your backyard, it's important to practice that stuff so you look good at it.
Now, you had mentioned going to local places. What kinds of things are in season right now? So that way, if we're going to, say, our local produce stand, we know what to look for.
Well, if I was in Philadelphia, I'd be starting to look for the beginning of the... I'd be looking probably for the middle of what were the strawberries. I'd be looking for the beginning of tomatoes and eggplants and zucchini. It's the same out here in Michigan. Right now, it's just about cherry harvest, so the cherry festival is about to kick in the second week of July. We're starting to think about what's happening out of the gardens. We're looking at early tomatoes. We're looking at some very interesting squashes, a lot of herbs. And then in the world of fisheries, there's a lot of lake trout right now and beautiful Lake Michigan whitefish. I try to find things that haven't spent a lot of time out of where they were grown before they get to the plate or the table.
Now, how much more important is it to go for those local aspects when we're choosing our food rather than going for something that you just find in the grocery store that might look good?
Well, finding something in the grocery store is still a great way to start. But what's really important, if you can support local farming, local produce, local butchers, local fishmongers, local cheesemakers, what you'll find is you're creating infrastructure for wherever you happen to live. And having people that are interested in making you delicious things in your society, in your group of whatever your community is called, then you're going to find that it's a much better and much more rich experience for everyone involved. Not only that, it's going to be more delicious. Food that spends less time from the moment it's plucked from wherever it lives to the time that it gets onto the plate at your house. The shorter that time, the better it's going to taste. It's going to be more remarkable, more delicious, and better for the planet overall without getting up on a big soapbox.
Now, what are some of your favorite dishes for summer to incorporate some of the foods that you already mentioned?
Well, something I'm making today at my house is something called a piadina, which is very much like a pie crust, a little flatbread dish. We grill it on one side, then we turn it over, put it on the slow side of the grill, and then I'm putting some local homemade or handmade bologna from a place called Plevis here in Cedar, and then I'm going to take some local cheese and then some cherries that are just being picked right now. I take the pits out of them, I dress them with a little balsamic vinegar and a little extra virgin olive oil, and I sprinkle them over it. So it's effectively kind of like an homage to prosciutto and melon, except I'm using bologna, cheese, and cheese from here, and a fresh hot bread. It's something that's so delicious and so easy. Makes it look good when you have your guests over.
That does sound very good. Now, is this something that is best with those local aspects that you picked, or is it okay if, say, maybe we don't have any cherry farms near us, we just go to the grocery store and get that?
Right, exactly. But there's got to be, I mean, I know Pennsylvania has some nice fruit in it, so if you could wait until there's an apricot season, you're right. But if you needed to use cherries, find cherries from the closest place that grows them for you and get them in season and on time. They'll cost less as well. Keep in mind, when things are in season, the supplies are up, so the price goes down. It makes it real easy to understand.
Now, with 4th of July coming up, what are some things that you recommend for dishes that we can make for those parties?
Well, the trick is making things that you can cook relatively quickly and that you can put together without spending too much time. Find some local fish. Here in Philadelphia, there's tons of great wild striped bass. There's tons of great bluefish. Put that stuff, wrap it up in foil with a little bit of lemon and some herbs and throw it right on the barbecue. You don't even have to look at it. You come back 6 or 7 minutes later, it's ready to eat.
Sounds great. And what other summer entertaining tips do you have for us?
Well, get your beverage program together before your guests get there. And don't serve 1,000 things at your bar. Put together a couple of nice non-alcoholic things. Have a nice wine and maybe some kind of a cocktail that you're putting together. But as opposed to trying to pretend you're a bar and serving everything anyone wants, just put together a couple of things that are real easy.
And also, what do you have coming up on future episodes of The Chew?
Oh, the chew's busy, and we're going to make different things, and we're celebrating the season as much as we can.
Great, and just one last question for you, Mario. Where can people go to find out more information and get more tips for summer entertaining?
Well, I'm a big fan of going to Michigan.org to see what kind of locally sourced ingredients are going on here. But you can go to my website to see what kind of cooking we're doing. It's really easy.
Sounds great, and thank you for coming on the program, Mario. It's been a pleasure
talking with you.
Have a great day.
All right, you too.
That was Mario Batali. He's a legendary chef. He's from Iron Chef on the Food Network. He's the star of the daytime talk show, The Chew, and he's an author of 9 cookbooks and the owner of 20 restaurants. That's a lot of stuff on his plate. And he is nationally recognized, renowned, fabulous cook, and it was such a pleasure to talk with him.